You're watching KCAL 9 News at noon.
Our guest today says throw everything you've ever heard or read about the benefits of antioxidant supplements and certain cosmetics out the window.
Yeah, don't think like that. A professor of chemistry at CSUN has written a book. It's called Guilty Until Proven Innocent. He joins us now. He's going to talk about his book and his theories. So we welcome Gagik Melikyan. Welcome, Professor.
Hi.
Hi, thanks. So I was a little bit surprised because all we've heard is that everything, all these supplements that we're supposed to be taking are good for us. And you say maybe not so fast.
Yeah. Well, the problem is that if we look at the antioxidants, which are identified in green tea, black tea, and also in red wine, and the number of compounds which are isolated from plant, all they belong to the family of organic compounds, which are called polyphenols. In fact, polyphenols these days is like a household name. You turn on TV, polyphenols, you while driving, you listening to the radio, polyphenols, polyphenols. Now, the problem is that polyphenols, by their very nature, they are like Trojan horses, because under certain conditions, if you test them, they can show antioxidant property, which is good for the body.
Right.
And under different conditions, they can act as a pro-oxidant. Now, the problem is that the general public hear the first part, and they don't hear the second part. The reason why I decided to write this book 4 years ago, just to share my knowledge, which is based on 37 years of professional experience working in the field of radical chemistry and organic and medicinal chemistry. And the book is written for the general public. It's also written for the professionals because it has a large number of references. But it's a book written for the general public for a layperson so that people with minimal or no scientific background can read and can understand it.
And what determines what characteristics the polyphenols are going to take on?
Well, the setting itself. The problem is that all these tests as antioxidants, they are done in test tubes. Now, the translational value for these tests is not high. This means that based on that experience, we cannot advise general public to take those compounds which have shown or demonstrated or exhibited antioxidant properties to put it inside the body. Because inside the body, there are certain enzymes, a large number of them, which can chemically modify these compounds. Now, the problem is that even 10 years ago, we didn't have this knowledge. Even 10 years ago, thousands of women were put on a hormone replacement therapy. Even 10 years ago, we didn't know that the high concentration of female hormone can cause breast cancer and other problems, other crippling diseases. Now we know this. And the antioxidants belong to the same family of phenols as the female hormone.
So just because it's natural for us, green tea, red wine, things like that, it might not necessarily be good for us.
Well, the problem is that the public is obsessed with the very concept of naturalness.
Mm-hmm.
And the separate chapter in the book is about naturalness. This is the perception that I would like to change by writing this book, that natural compound doesn't automatically mean that the compound is beneficial or compound is benign. Natural compounds can kill people the same way as any bad synthetic compound which is synthesized in the laboratory. And I hope that with this book, I'm just contributing to this understanding. And people who have attended my public presentations, I have made 5-6 public presentations already in LA area, and more are planned. And people who bought this book, which is available on Amazon, by the way, they admit that reading this book, it becomes like an eye-opening and life-changing experience because they don't hear this from any other source.
I guess hemlock and poison ivy are natural too, aren't they?
Right?
This is the thing. And during my presentation, sometimes I said, look at the snake venom. Snake venom looks very good. It's a nice yellow compound, but in fact it kills too fast. It's still natural.
What is your concern about something like sunscreen? What does that have in it that I should be concerned about?
Well, this is completely a different issue, and there are several issues over here. First of all, the public perception is that if we are applying what is called topically, so this is a topical application, most probably it doesn't go inside the body. And we can see again and again and again when we go to the beach, right, to enjoy nice California weather, people are arriving, families. As soon as they arrive, they cover themselves, parents, and also their kids liberally with a huge amount of sunscreen. And on many occasions, I just couldn't see that. I approach people and ask them, do you realize that these gram quantities of compounds that you're applying on your skin goes inside your body. And people didn't realize that this is, in fact, the same as taking pills or taking food or drinking beverage. Another problem is that I have to say I don't understand this obsession for many to become darker than they are. Because sometimes people spend hours and hours on the beach or lying at the pool, and they become much darker. Sometimes they go back, even their pets cannot recognize them. This is the thing. And the public, if they read the book, they will understand that there is a very high price to pay, because they are doing the chemical reaction all over the body just to become a little bit darker.
It's a lot to think about. Thank you so much for joining us.
Yeah, my pleasure.
Thank you. If you want more information about Professor Melikyan's eye-opening advice, just visit our website. It's kcal9.com. You can click Scene on TV.
Very interesting.
Thank you, Professor.
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yeah.
The rain has moved out, and we're making way for some sunshine.